Okay, good morning to all of you. So today we are studying about the multiple objectives of a business. So we have in the previous class, we have studied about the multiple objectives of a business and a few objectives we have already studied. Is it clear to you? Am I audible? Can you listen to me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are studying about the multiple objectives of business and few objectives we have already studied. That is a market standing. So, you know, so market standing means that remain in the market or remain in the industry for a longer duration. So start a company and create a reputation. We have studied about goodwill. You know. So if a company wants to be in the market for a longer duration, it should create a goodwill. So it should have a goodwill and it has to continue in the market for a longer duration. Means we can say that the companies are living not in the market, but in the mind of the customers, we can say. So if a good company is there, so if I tell you about, when we speak about a particular product, so there is some particular brands which is coming into our mind. So that is the value of the brand, or we can say that the brand value, or we can say that this is the power or market standing of a business. Okay, so like if you consider, like when we say about mobile phones, the most probably we think about like MI, or Xiaomi, which is a company called Xiaomi, and its product is MI. So this brand is now one of the leading company in the mobile industry, and it has got other products also, like supportive products like headphones or such type of products are also available. Okay, when you compare about like a pen drive, okay, so then there is a company called SanDisk. So most of the time we get into many of the pen drives that we see is produced by a company called SanDisk. And when you think about a laptop, the main name comes into our mind is Dell or Toshiba or HP or all these type of names are there. So these companies have got a goodwill. So that is the main element, or that is the way that the companies are being in the market. So these companies are there in the market. When you think about cars, we get the name of Maruti. Maruti cars are there. Even though there are so many, and when you come about some trucks or other vehicles are there, when you consider automobile industry as a whole, we get the name of Tata, So Tata is a famous name. When you think about petrol and other type of products like that, Reliance is there, and Hindustan Petroleum is there. Okay, Indian Oil is there. All these names comes into our mind. So when you just think about any product, there's a name comes into our mind, a company will be there in our mind. So this power is, this is the goodwill of a company, and this helps the company to be in the market for a longer duration. The company has been serving the people, and they are living in the, we can say that they are living in the minds of the customers. Okay. Then the next we studied about the innovation. So innovation means that's bringing something new, bring something new into the market. So this will be in the product, either in the way of a product or in the way of producing a product. Two types of innovations are there. So it may be like a new product will be there. So any change in the product will be there, or in there will be a change in the method of producing a product. Okay, so a new method of producing will be there. So this new method can reduce the cost of the product and increase the profit. So when cost is reduced, we normally get a higher profits. And we studied about the productivity. Productivity is the comparison between the value of input that we use for producing a product and the value of output. Okay, so how much input that we are giving in and how much output we are getting. So this comparison will be there, and based on this comparison, we can say that how much productivity the company is giving. So if you have 1 acre of land, and if you produce wheat, how much output you are getting, how much input, how much money you have to spend for the production, and how much output you are getting. And if you consider about any other product, maybe like a sugar cane or such type of products are there, then how much input you will be getting. Okay, input you are giving and how much output you will be getting. So these kinds of things has to be considered. Okay, that is about the productivity. The next important feature that we have to study is about the physical and the financial resources. Okay, so physical as well as financial resources. Any business requires physical, like resources like plants, machines, offices, etc. So there are physical resources. Physical resources, like for a school, the physical resources required for a school is that there should be a proper building, there should be proper rooms should be there, some land will be there for like a playground, basketball court, football court, or like all these type of things. So the infrastructure that we are having, that is the physical resources, yes or no? So if we consider, we look into the physical factors, yes or no? So if you consider, like if there is a school, if you consider that the school is to be bigger, then we can say that mostly people consider about the size of the building that they are having. You know, if the school is having a big building, we say that this is a big school. And if the size of the school is, or the building is small, then we consider that as a small building or small school. Okay. So when you consider about a business, a shop, if you consider a shop, you can say the size of the shop. You know, so how much size is there, how much area is there of the shop, how much square feet area is there, all these type of things are considered. Okay, so we can say that there are so many type of things are there, infrastructures are there, like plants, machines, offices, the buildings are there, or the machines that their company is having, all these type of things are physical resources, whichever things we can see, we have it, whichever things that we are having, that is called as the physical resources. Okay, and other than this, there are also and financial resources, like funds to be able to produce and supply goods and services to its customers. Financial resources are also required. The money, or we can say that is about the financial resources, the materials or the fund that we are having, money that we are having. So how much amount of money is there, how much capital is there, how much fund the company is having for running the business. That is called as the financial resources. So these two things are considered. So physical as well as the financial resources. Okay. The business enterprise must aim at acquiring these resources according to their requirements and use them effectively. Okay. So efficiently. So the purpose of these organizations or a business firm is to make use of the resources in a proper manner. So first, the business unit has to acquire or get a number of resources. Okay, so these resources are there. There is a school. The purpose of the school is to make like purchase land, make building, make nice classrooms. There should be nice facilities should be there for the students. There should be ground for playing. There should be facility for the transportation, like buses and other type of things are there. So all these type of physical resources required, and we have to maintain these resources and make use of the resources. Like imagine that's like nowadays we are having school, we are having a building, everything is there, but we are unable to, students are unable to come to the school. So we like now see like purchase like laptops are there, that other equipments are there, cameras are there, all these type of things we have purchased, and we are running the class. So according to the situation, we will have to adjust with the situation. Okay, so there will be different type of situations. There will be some kind of problems that we may be facing. So at that time, we should be ready to do that. So for doing these things, what we need is that money is required, financial resources required. So both these things are very much essential. So we should acquire large number of resources, as well as we should make use of them in a proper manner. Okay, so that is the another objective of a organization. Okay, the next objective that we have to use is that earning profits. One of the objectives of a business is to earn profit on the capital employed. Profitability refers to the profit in relation to the capital investment. Every business must earn a reasonable profit, which is so important for its survival and growth. So for a company, the another important objective of an organization or a business is to earn profit. Making profit is the one of the most important objective of an organization. So if the company is unable to make profit, it means that the company is a failure. Okay, if a company is unable to make profit, the company's management is not done properly, and it cannot run in the business for a longer duration. The company cannot run for a longer duration. But if the company is having sufficient amount of profit, if the company is able to earn good profit, then the company can run for a longer period. For a future, in the future, the company can make more profit and continue doing business. And it will help the company for its survival as well as its growth, for growing. So increasing, see, like as I told you, if we have like the financial, the physical resources that we are having, if we are making more profit, we will be able to make purchase more land, make more building, and make other infrastructures. So physical resources, if we are having, getting good profit, then we can increase the physical resources. If we don't have such an amount of profit, then it is very difficult for the company to increase its other resources. So earning profit is a very much important important objective of a business. So the every business try to earn a good amount of profit. The next one, manager performance and development. Business enterprises need managers to conduct and coordinate business activity. Various programs for motivating managers need to be implemented. Manager performance and development, therefore, is an important objective. The enterprises must actively work for this purpose. So every organization should try to, or every business organization, every business has to see to it that their managers are improving. There is some improvement in the managers. Like if there is a school, then we can say that there should be development of the teachers. So if there is development of the teachers, if the quality of the teachers are increasing, normally the quality of the students will increase. So this is connected together. So there is like for some trainings and some programs, all these type of things are organized for the teachers. So every year or every time we will have some or the other programs are organized for the teachers for increasing their efficiency, increasing their talents. So every managers in an organization, in a business unit, every manager's performance or every manager's capability has to be increased. They should work more. They should provide some features, some facilities for the improvement of their managers. So if the managers are becoming more and more capable, if the managers become more responsible, they will be able to do the job in a better manner. Means they will be able to handle the job, and they will be motivating the employees, and the performance of the organization will be increasing. Okay. So managers performance and development is the another objective. Worker performance and attitude. Workers performance and attitude determine their contribution towards productivity and profitability of any enterprise. Therefore, every enterprise must aim at improving its workers' performance. It should also try to ensure a positive attitude on the part of the workers. Another important aspect of a business is the performance of the workers. So a success of an organization is mainly depending on its workers. Okay. See, like if I say that if the success of our school is depending on you all, all the students are there. So how is your performance? So if if we compare the school with the other school, then we can say that it depends on the way on, or we can say it depends on the performance of the students. If the students are performing nicely, we see to it that the 10th class result is there or 12th class result is there. And when the result comes, how much output that we are getting, how much, how many 90 plus students are there, how many 80 plus students are there, how many of them passed. All these type of things we will consider. And also like the topper of the school, how much is the mark of the topper of the school, all these type of things are considered. So imagine that if we are having very nice infrastructure, very nice buildings are there, very like AC classrooms are there, very nice chairs are there, and you are sitting very relaxedly and enjoying very nice, all the facilities are provided to you. And the teachers are also very well qualified and they are coming and they are teaching very nice. But imagine if the students are not performing, is there any benefit to that school? There is no any benefit, isn't it? In the same way, if in a business unit, if the infrastructure, if the business is having very big, like imagine that if they are having very nicer building is there, they have all the machines are there very nicely performing, and the managers are also very nicely there working there. But the workers are not doing any work, or they are very lazy, they are not ready to cooperate with the managers. If such a situation is there, that business will not be successful. Okay. Mind that is like if there is a shop. Okay. So if there is a shop, like if you in Haria, if you consider like a Grahika is there, okay, or like that one margin free shop is there. So very big shop is there, and almost all the products and all are kept there, arranged there, everything, and there is also managers are there. But there are some workers are there, so the sales people are there, they are standing. So if you are going to the shop and you are asking for some product, and if that shopkeeper, if that salesman is not behaving properly with you, and he is saying that if you are asking for a product, and he is saying that no, this product is not available, and if there is any other brand, so if whatever things that you are asking, they are not responding properly, so what happens? You stop going to that shop. So you will never go to that shop. So it is, if you want to, if there's a good shop, or if you want to be, if you want to run a good business, the first thing that you have to maintain, or the important thing that you have to do, is to have the very, very qualified workers. So if you go to a hotel for having food, so the hotel will be very big. Okay. And there are nice chairs, are there nice table is there, and AC room is there, nice prices are there. And if that person who is coming there, and food service also is very nice. But imagine that if the, like that person who is coming to serve you, the servants are there, the people, those who are coming. So they are coming and they are not behaving properly with you. So you may not feel comfortable there, isn't it? So, but when you go to some good hotels and all, you will find that these people, they come and they speak very nicely. They are very trained people are there. If you go to a good, like a star hotels and all, you will find that these people, they have already done courses. Okay, so they studied. See, like my brother, he is studying in a hotel. Okay, so he is working in Ernakulam. He is working in a five-star hotel. And he is he has already completed MMH, Master of Management in Hospitality. One course is there. Okay, so he has already studied BTS. One course is there. Bachelor of Tourism Studies in his degree, and he has completed Master of Management in Hospitality. It's almost equal to MBA. Okay, so both this course he has completed. What is this? Is that Kritika? Okay, so he has completed the course and he is working there. So all the employees working there over there are trained people, very well qualified people. So the customers, those who are coming, see, for one room, so the rent of one room is minimum 5,000 rupees, starting from 5,000. It is from 5,000 to, it is, there are rooms for 30,000, 40,000. 50,000 per day, one room, 24 hours, you have to stay there for that. And they will provide, and additionally, you will have food and other type of things will be there. Okay. So just for staying one day, you have to pay around 5,000, 6,000, 10,000, 12,000 like that. So that is the cost of the rooms there. Okay. And he is working as a connecting or like banquet coordinator. So some functions and all are there. So he is organizing the functions like big companies, they organize their meetings and so on. So such kind of activities he is conducting. Okay. So this is there. So if you go to a restaurant or if you go to a good hotel, you will find that the employees, they come and they may stand there in a very decent way. They wear a very good dress and they come and they ask you, what would you like to have? So, or they will give you the menu and they will ask you, what would you like to have? Or they will speak. And they mostly, you see, like if you go to a 3-star or 5-star restaurant, you will find that the employees, the servants, those who are there, they also are able to speak in English. Most probably, if you go to city areas and all, you will find. Or if you go to Delhi or even in Lucknow and all, if you go in cities, if you go to hotels, if you go, you will find that the people, those who are there, they are speaking in English, they're speaking in Hindi or any different languages they are knowing. So they will be able to speak very well, and they speak with a very polite words, because they are already trained. If you travel in the flight, you will find that there are air hostess are there. So all they are also there, they are already trained, or you can say that there are like people, those who are working in the ground clearance or ground support workers are there. So they are there, they, you know, they have studied their course for 2 or 3 years, and after that they have all the training they are receiving, and after that they are coming. So they speak in a very nice manner. They are ready to do any service for you. Okay, so they make you comfortable in the way that you are doing. When we are traveling, or when you want to go to a hotel, or when you have the food, they'll provide all the facilities. So these are the workers, so their performance, their way of behaving. And depending on the way that they are speaking, depending on the way they are behaving, we feel comfortable, isn't it? So if they are behaving nicely, so we feel very much comfortable there. We enjoy being there, isn't it? So that is the most important thing, the performance of the workers. Then the last responsibility is about the social responsibility. Social responsibility refers to the obligation of business firms to contribute resources for solving social problems and work in a socially desirable manner. Okay. So social responsibility, every organization, every business has got some social responsibility. They have got some social responsibility. So the social responsibility means that the organization or the business has to provide good quality products to the customers. They should see to it that they don't pollute the environment when they are like their factories there or industries there, when they are producing the product. Normally what happens is that the products may get, they will, when they are producing earlier, you might have seen if there is a factory. So they start the factory in a nearby river. So why do they start the factory nearby a river? Means that the waste which is coming has to be deposited into the river. So for that purpose, they mostly start the factory nearby a river. So the waste water will be there. So much waste contents will be coming from the factory, so that they were depositing into the river. But nowadays we can say, and also they have very big pipes are there, chimneys are there. So from the chimneys, there will be smoke coming out. Okay. So they will create a lot amount of air pollution. You know, so you might have seen that, say like in Pafnan, there is a that chini mill is there. So you can see when you go near, first nearby, when you travel nearby that mill, you can find, I was there in Pafnan a few years back. So at that time when I was there, if we have to travel from that railway station, nearby the railway station, if you are traveling, you will find that so much amount of sound is, okay, one thing. Then when you go nearby that factory area, you will find that so much black colored dust is falling on the road also. So much dust is there. So that sugarcane, after that juice is removed, that waste is coming. So they are transporting these things. And the road that over that area was very much poor. Means very low quality road was there. Okay, if the trucks are traveling, so then so many trucks are there. So that is getting disturbed there. And also if that, see like after that waste, one material is coming, so that one smell is coming. If you go to that, if you cross the road and go to that side, there is an area where they are dumping the waste, is it not? So you, after the crossing on the other side, you will find that there is a area where they are depositing the waste there. So if you travel to that nearby that area, that's a lot amount of some stingy smell will be coming, is it not? So, and also on the air, if you consider that just on the top of the factory, if you watch, you will find that so much of a smoke is coming out from there. So people living nearby that area, they may be getting affected by these things. Isn't it? So they, if there is a factory nearby, so they create, if there is like such kind of waste materials are coming, and if they are depositing in the normal area, it will create a land pollution. Okay, so they are creating so much amount of dust, so much amount of smoke is coming out. So such a way it will create air pollution. Okay, and if they are depositing the waste materials into the river, then it will create a water pollution. So if earlier the factories were there, so they are creating all sorts of pollutions. But now we can say that the industries, they have to reduce the amount of so there is so much amount of, like, as a part of their social responsibility, it is the responsibility of the business or your organization to reduce the amount of, it is not possible that zero pollution is not possible. Then also they should try to reduce the amount of pollution, so they should not disturb the people around that area much. So with a factory, we have also so much amount of benefits are there. Okay, so they are providing so many employment opportunities to the people over there. So many people are getting job, many people are good, getting good salary, and the standard of the living of the people will increase. Yes, you know. So such a area will develop. So much benefits are there. At the same time, there are also some negative points like that. Okay. So when there is a factory, if there is a factory working in that area, the factory should see to it that they don't pollute the environment. They should support the society. Yes, you know. So they should help the society by providing good employment opportunities. They should provide people. They should give job to the people nearby that area so that they will get a job facilities and they will get a good salary. So people will be able to be happy nearby that area. Yes, you know. So that is the one benefit that they have to provide. They should see to it that much pollution is not created, and also they should support in the activities of the area. See, like if from Bafnan to from here to Bafnan, the road is here. So you will find that this factory members, they come and once in a year they used to clean that. It's that they will, if there are big gutters and all, they put some mud and all, and they will fill up that. So some works they were doing earlier. Now the road has already been made proper. So the road is quite good. So there is no much issues. Earlier when I was traveling, or when I was there in Bafnan at that time, so if I have to travel from there to here, it will take some around 18 kilometers distance, but it will take around 1 hour time by bike if we are coming. 45 minutes, 1 hour, because so many gutters are there. If you go into one gutter, then you will come up. It is like as you are traveling in a seesaw and all, isn't it? So if you are traveling in such a way, it was there. So the condition of the road was very poor. But now everything has made it ready. So the people, so this is because of the support of the that factory also. The members of that factory, they supported. They have their political support and all. With the help of that, they have made this road ready so that any much disturbance is not there. So they are doing some benefit to the people around, to their society. So they should make a benefits to the people. Okay, so that is the most important. So they should have some social responsibility also has to be maintained. Thus, a business enterprise must have multiple objectives to satisfy different individuals and groups. This is essential for its own survival and prosperity. So there are around eight things that we have studied, 8 points that we have studied. All these objectives have to be kept in mind. Each and every objectives have to be maintained. Then only the business organization can be successful. Okay, and also the organization can grow. So objectives will help the business organization to grow their prosperity, their growth, and for their development. These objectives are very much necessary. Okay, so that is about the topic, multiple objectives of business. If you have any doubts regarding this one, you may ask now. You can switch on.
What is fund?
Pardon?
What is fund?
Your voice is not coming clear. What is fund? Okay. So what is fund? Fund means money. Okay. Fund. Fund means the money, or we can say that it is the amount of capital invested, or the money that we are using for the running of a business. Okay. So the resource, finance, money, or fund. That means the capital or the money that we are using. So we can say that it is the money that we are using for the day-to-day activities of the organization. Okay. So the capital means that the money that we have invested for purchasing of raw materials, purchasing of these fixed assets. Okay. So that is coming in the category of capital. And the fund means that the amount that we are, it includes all the money, but mainly it is depending on the money that we are investing for a day-to-day activities of the business. We need money, you know. Or we can say like it is a working capital, the money that we are keeping in the organization for the day-to-day activities. So fund simply means money, or that money that we are using for the business purposes. Any other doubts? Still there are many, only one or two or a very few of you are coming. You are keeping your videos on. Actually, there are around 10 participants are there. In that, I find only two members are keeping their videos on. And others are keeping your videos off. So if your videos are off, there is no any meaning in conducting live class. So you have to see me and I have to see you. Then only it will become live. Otherwise, it is, if you are able to see me, you can just see the class like that. Then it is just like a recorded class. So try to be live. Okay, so if there are some network issues are there, but you try to be live most of the time. You try to be videos should be on, so that I can also see that you are listening. So I feel comfortable, and if you have any kind of clarifications required, you can ask. Okay. So this is a new topic or a new study book that you are going to study, or new subject, isn't it? So until 10th class, you are not studying this one. So mutual fund. There is a slight difference between mutual fund. Fund means the money that we are investing in the business, but mutual fund is another term. Okay, it is not just insurance. Mutual fund is almost equal to shares. Okay, so this he had asked about the mutual funds. It is fund means money. So as I told you, so mutual fund means it is the group fund, we can say. Okay, so mutual fund is the kind of system. This is like if we, like there are people, those who are purchasing the shares. Okay, so if I can purchase share and I can make share trading, but if I am not knowing much about share trading, and if I do, if I purchase some shares, I may lose my money, or I don't have so much time to spend on this one. See, like if I have to do share trading, then what is there means that I have to like be online. I have to watch when the share price is going up, when it is going down, all these things I have to watch. Then only I will be able to do the share trading. But they see, some people are there that they are not able to do this kinds of activities. So what you can do is that there are some companies providing mutual fund. So mutual fund means that it is collecting. So you can deposit a fixed amount of money to the mutual fund. See, for example, you are taking, imagine that you are investing 2000 rupees every month. Okay, so you can invest any amount of money to a mutual fund. And that money, the company will be there. See, for example, if I am having a bank account in a PNB, Punjab National Bank, okay. So in Punjab National Bank, I am having an account, and in Punjab National Bank is providing mutual fund facility. Different companies are providing mutual fund. Okay, different mutual funds are there. So what I have to do is that I have to invest some money into this. So I can invest some 5,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees or 1 lakh rupees, 2 lakh rupees, whatever may be the amount that I am investing. Okay, and the money that I am investing, with that money, the company will be doing share trading. Okay, they will be investing this money. So if I am giving this money to PNB, and PNB will be investing this money into share market, and they already trained people are there, though they have already studied about the share market, share trading, they are experienced share traders are there. So they understand, they will be watchful about the different companies, whichever is successful. So the successful companies are there. So to those companies, they will be investing this money and they will make profit. And one part of the share profit that the company is getting will be given to us. Okay, so that is called as the mutual fund. Okay, it is almost equal to share. So but it is just like you are money depositing money into the bank, is it not? So you can deposit money into the bank in the same way you can deposit it into the mutual fund. So you can purchase the mutual fund, and you may have to wait for a longer duration. See, like if you are to, see, like you invest money today, and next month if you want to take back money, you may not get much benefit. But if you want to invest money today, and if you are interested to take back maybe after 2-3 months or maybe after 2-3 years, so in such a way, if you are investing, it will get a more benefit. But you have to see to it where there are so many mutual fund companies are there. So which company is providing you better profits? So all these type of things we have to understand and invest money. Okay, is it clear to you? Okay, so if you don't have any other doubts, then we will conclude for today. Okay, thank you so much.